Welcome to Viking Basketball with Barret Peery. As the Vikings get ready to close out their non-conference schedule, and they have three very challenging games coming up. Portland State playing at BYU on Wednesday. They are home right here in the Viking Pavilion Saturday night playing Loyola Marymount. And then next week on the 20th, they host Cal State Bakersfield again here at home. Coach, as we kind of wind up that non-conference schedule, it's a pretty tough slate, but probably one that's going to prepare you as you head into conference play.
Yeah, it looked a lot better in June when we finished it all up. But no, those teams are good, and we want to be challenged. We want to have good home games. We want to go on the road and be challenged as well and experience what we need to experience so we can be prepared for what's really important, which is January and February.
All right, we'll look back real quickly. The Vikings currently 5-3 as we record this, looking ahead to the BYU game. And the thing that everybody's talking about is that great win last week on this court against the University of Portland. The Vikings winning that one 87-78. And we'll talk about a few individual players. And first and foremost, we got to talk about Boo Boo. Holland Woods, tremendous game, 27 points. He hit 5 3-pointers in the first half. That was a career high, and he got it done in the first 20 minutes. You had to feel pretty good about his play because not only did he score, he distributed well, kind of controlled the pace.
Yeah, he did. He controlled it. He makes us go, as you know. And you know, I thought he got his rhythm going. He hit a couple shots. And so then, you know, he felt pretty confident to take a few more. And we have great confidence in him. He did a good job. But like you said, also, you know, he really made us go. He got the assists going. He got people in the right spots and really got the pace of the game going for us when we needed it to go.
And the other thing we're seeing here in non-conference play, and I call them the newcomers, Michael Nuga, Sal Nuhu, playing extremely well off the bench. In fact, they're the second and third leading scorers on the team, and you have to be really pleased. A couple of newcomers have come in, grasped that system, doing what you want to do and producing.
Yeah, they fit us. You know, I think that how they play and you know, their mentality, they play really hard. Sal plays really hard. Nuga plays really hard. Nuga can obviously shoot the ball, and he's getting more and more comfortable. He's finding his windows of opportunity and where his shots are going to come. Boo-Boo's doing a good job finding him as well. And then Sal has been, you know, you can talk about his points and some things like that, but he's been a great energy bunny for us. He's really given us a lift a lot of times, blocking shots, running the floor and finishing. He's got a great voice, you know, and then he scored the ball around the rim. He's done a great job.
And as we look ahead to the upcoming games, your roster, you play everybody, and this roster is actually going to expand a little bit. This week should get Michael Mayhew back, and that's important because he led the Vikings with 66 three-point field goals last season. The Vikings need some more shooting, and Vontae Carter also coming back. So that kind of expands your roster, gives you a few more options.
Yeah, we've missed those guys, especially on the road. Not just playing time, but they're seniors and they're leaders and they have great voices and they know how we do things. And so I've missed those guys a lot, even if they weren't playing. So now to have an opportunity for them to play, like you said, Mike really shoots the ball well. And he knows our system. He knows me. He's another good security blanket for me, or a guy that when you put him in the game, he knows what to do and how we play.
And if you saw that Viking win over Portland, you know that was really truly inspired by a great effort on the backboards by Portland State, almost doubling up the Pilots in terms of number of rebounds. A guy who's done a great job for you this year in that area, Jamie Orme, had 13 in the game. I know he was a key to that. But I think you got the victory playing the way you guys wanted to play.
Yeah, that was, you know, kind of – one of those games where we just leaned on what we do. You know, when we don't shoot the ball great, we're still going to go to the offensive glass. That's a huge emphasis for us. And for us to go get 27 of them, Jamie got 7. I thought Rashad Goolsby was really good. Sal was good on the glass. Everybody went. Everybody did their job. When we didn't make it or we didn't get it, we were ready to defend. And so, you know, we got those extra points and opportunities on the glass, and it showed.
Worth noting, Vikings leading the nation right now in offensive rebounding, just over 20 per game. That's pretty impressive for short guys like me and semi-short guys like you.
Yeah.
But that's really what you brought to the team, that rebounding effort, the pressure defense, and just creating opportunities. I think I added up something like close to 160 extra possessions based on turnover differential and offensive rebound differential so far this season.
Yeah, and we haven't always made teams pay. You know, I've been really frustrated in a couple of our losses because I thought we did a good job on the glass but didn't make teams pay, especially Stanford. When we got to the offensive glass, we had 24 of them there and lost a close game and had opportunities. But, again, it's early. It's preseason. A lot of new guys on our team, but they are playing the way we want to play. They're doing their jobs, and it looks how it's supposed to look. And so I'm excited. This team has a lot of opportunity for growth. We got these three good games coming up. You know, most importantly, the next one, which is at BYU.
And let's talk about BYU for just a minute. The Cougars 7-4, and they have a couple of stars that lead them, and you can address that a little bit. But the other element that they bring in is a great home venue with very big crowds, averaging about 12,000 a night. So that's going to be a little bit of a different environment for the Vikings.
Yeah, you know, I grew up right down the road from there, and that place has always been special as far as crowds, and I lived it when I was at Utah as the rival many times, 20,000 plus in those games. But they have really good players, and they got two or three stars for sure, like you mentioned. Yoli Childs, I believe, is the only 2010 guy in the nation right now. He's a guy that you'll see in the NBA. He really can score the ball. He's going to get his touches. He's going to get his shots. What we need to do is be smart, not foul him, and make him work for everything he gets. And then TJ Haas has really scored the ball well for them. And on top of that, getting five assists a game.
Childs averaging about 23 points, 12 rebounds a game. Shoots it extremely well. 6'8", so that'll be quite a challenge for some of your big guys. And then Saturday night, right here in the pavilion, Loyola Marymount comes in, and this is a vastly improved Marymount team. 9-1 this season. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about them and what the challenge is there.
Well, I haven't been able to watch them a ton, but obviously you see their scores and you see where they're at. Like you said, 9-1. He's doing a great job with this team. He's got a group that's really buying into what they do. You know, my assistant coaches and I were talking about them last night. They have a system of how they want to play. You know, I think simply put, on Saturday you'll see a battle of wills a little bit. I don't think they want to run and be up and down with us. And so they'll try to control pace, and we'll try to be the opposite of that. And really speed them up. We won at their place last year, speeding them up and getting them in bad spots with turnovers, and we'll have to do that again to a degree this year.
So a contrast in styles on Saturday night. And then on the 20th, last game before the Christmas holiday, and that is Cal State Bakersfield. They are currently 5-4. You look at who they played, though. I believe they beat Idaho on the road, and I believe they've also beaten Weber State this year. So that's a team that's got a pretty good resume.
They do, and Coach Baker does a good job with them. And they've gone on the road and played some really good teams. They took TCU to the wire, and I just saw TCU beat USC on the weekend by like 30. So they got a good group. They got a bunch of athletes, and he does a good job.
All right, the Vikings ready to go?
We are. It's going to be a good stretch. We're excited. We'd love to have a couple good crowds these last two games before Christmas, and the guys are excited.
Yeah, Vikings had a great crowd against the Pilots. Obviously, a school is out. The finals were last week. Maybe not as many students. So get on down here and root on your Vikings. Big games coming up leading into the holidays. For all the information on Portland State Vikings basketball, go to govikes.com.